Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to implement CI/CD pipeline on Kubernetes cluster using Jenkins. My Jenkins is running on Kubernetes cluster. I am going to create a scripted pipeline to build and test a Java application and then creating a Docker image, finally upload on Docker Hub. I am creating dynamical ports for Jenkins agent. Give the name of your choice to labels. Kubernetes will create pod with name Kubernetes like this. I am creating two containers. One container for build and test Java application by using Maven. And second container we require to create a Docker image. Since both the containers are located in same ports, hence they are sharing same storage and network. In this container, we are going to download our application code and build and test by using Maven. This container will use the package file that is created by this container to build a Docker image and upload on Docker Hub. We are mounting this directory on Docker container. Let me explain why. We require a Docker client or Docker engine to build a Docker image, and we are creating a Docker container for this purpose. We can say that we are running Docker in Docker. Now this Docker container needs to talk Docker daemon service on the host, and this file establish a communication between Docker engine and Docker daemon service on host machine. This is a tag name of the image, version and Jenkins build number. This is image name. When you upload image on Docker Hub, you have to follow the standard format. This is a standard format of image name, your Docker Hub username and image name. This is a location where my source code is located. My Docker file is located here. And application code is located inside this folder. I am defining this variable because my code is located inside the code folder. I am providing the node in a pipeline, but all the execution will be on Kubernetes pod. Kubernetes creates pods for every agent. In the first stage, it is going to clone source code on the agent. Git is cloning the source code. In this location, I started container Maven for the build process, and I am performing the build process on code folder because my source code is located in this folder. I am performing the unit test and storing report on this location. After completion of build process, I am starting container Docker to build a image. In this step, I am building a image by using my Docker file. This is my Docker file. I am using the base image Tomcat 8.0 because my application code is not working with the higher version of Tomcat, and I am copying the var file from this location to this location. I stored my Docker Hub credential in Jenkins. Go to credentials. And stored your Docker Hub credential there. In this step, I am logging on my Docker Hub account, and finally I am uploading my image on Docker Hub. Let's create a new project in Jenkins for this pipeline. Let's create a pipeline. Go to pipeline and copy the code, save it. Let's go ahead and build now. I am also watching the pod activity in Jenkins namespace. A new pod created. It will take some time to be complete. You can see all the progress on console output. Cloning has been started. Build stage started. Build successfully completed. Test activity has been started. Test has been completed. In this step, we started to build a Docker image. Successfully build a Docker image. We are trying to log in on Docker Hub. And finally, we are uploading the Docker image on Docker Hub. The entire process successfully completed. Let's verify the Docker image on Docker Hub. This is my Docker image. And this is the tag name. If you see the life cycle of the pod, then you will realize that pods are creating when pipeline started with three containers and getting terminate after completion of the pipeline. It creates three containers in a pod. One container for the agent where it is cloning the application code. Second container for the Maven for the build a application code. And third container for the Docker to build and upload Docker image. Since all containers in same pod, hence they are sharing same storage and network. In this video, that's all. In next video, we are going to release or deploy this image on Kubernetes cluster. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.